I've been using Unity for a few years now. I initially installed it along with the baked-in Visual Studio community, as it's only a few clicks to do so. Pretty obvious, huh? Well, after a long while, I started getting tired of using Visual Studio. Even though it is great and is one of the best IDEs that you can get for free at that, it manages to check so many boxes. Watch until the end if you want to see how to set Rider up for the Unity and Unreal game engines. My problem, however, wasn't the greatness of Visual Studio. Despite of all its advantages, it's slow, takes too long to start up, not to mention the amount of space it holds up in your system. Thankfully, there are alternatives to using Visual Studio for Unity. Microsoft's very own Visual Studio Code is a great lightweight, small, and fast text editor / IDE that you can use for many languages, including Unity's scripting API with C#. But I wanted to try something else. Whenever you go into the package manager of any Unity project, assuming you haven't removed it, you will always find this package called JetBrains Rider for Unity pre-installed. Obviously, if you don't use Rider, it makes sense to remove the package as it takes up precious space. But what if you do want to use it? Naturally, I took the next logical step. I googled Rider for Unity and found its official website. If you've ever used any JetBrains product before, you know that the IDEs they make are very good and tightly integrated with whatever you want to do. On the page, through text, videos, and GIFs, JetBrains claims that Rider has a better control over the editor, coding hints, debugging, testing, finding usages, among other things. Moreover, it is cross-platform. Even though Visual Studio is available for macOS, it is a crippled version. Microsoft's own website has a comparison table that shows a few things are missing. But JetBrains' website takes a more detailed and focused comparison towards Unity-specific features. If you do use Unity on a Mac, using Rider is a no-brainer, if you can get your hands on it, that is. Which brings me to my next point. Being a part of the JetBrains suite of IDEs, Rider is a paid product, costing as of recording $249 for the first year or $2490 per month if you get the entire suite. That's almost 18,500 rupees for the first year or 1850 rupees per month. Clearly, I did not want to shell out that much. So I fumbled around the website and found that they do have a student plan in which they offer their entire suite of products free for a year. There are a few ways of signing up for this. However, the best way is to sign up through GitHub. Apply for the student developer pack on GitHub, and once you get accepted, not only do you get the JetBrains products, but also a whole host of other things, which are very useful. After receiving a confirmation email from JetBrains, log into their website, go through the licensing agreement and hit accept. Next, download and install Rider and allow for the .cs and .cs proj extensions, maybe even a few more if you know what you are doing, and click on the add path option. Once the installation is finished, it'll prompt you to reboot your PC. After rebooting, launch Rider and sign in using the same account that you used on the JetBrains website. You can choose your themes, fonts, and even key mapping. I use Visual Studio's key maps since they've been mapped to my memory now. Now, over in Unity, open the project manager and make sure you have the Rider package installed. Next, change the default IDE from the preferences menu . And that's it. You may want to change a few settings in Rider and enable a few useful features, such as showing asterisk on modification, and that's it. A fresh paint of code for your coding journey. If you're not a student or a teacher, see if you fit into any of the other special offer groups. If you don't, but if you can afford the subscription, it's definitely worth it. Just for Unity, you don't need to sign up for the entire thing. You can get Rider for $1,390 a month or $139 a year. There's a second part of this video coming up that will show you how to get Rider for the Unreal Engine, and trust me, getting it working for Unreal is much more difficult than it is for Unity. So if you're interested in that, be subscribed and hit that notification bell so you can be among the first to watch it. Make sure to hit the like button if you liked the video, or the dislike button if you disliked it. Comment down your thoughts and share it with someone who's still using Visual Studio. Stay safe, and if it's available in your city, get the vaccine. All right, I will see you later. Thanks for watching and have a good day, or a good night, whenever you're watching this.